And a very good morning. It's Friday, the 1st of February, 8:30. We've already got the round six of VFS done. Ralph Caudry was here. He's off for a little bit of a break. Pete Allen joins us now in the studio. Morning, Pete.
Morning, Regan. Muggle mode.
Ray Ahmed's here as well. They're going to be taking us through the expert commentary on the formation skydiving, which is starting in a couple of minutes' time. Let's have a quick recap of yesterday's action, guys.
So I guess the first thing to look at will be the female category.
Yeah, definitely.
Where we have a very clear point spread.
Yeah, right. Very much so. So Neftis Wimby are in the front on 131 points after the five rounds. And following them with a 5-point difference is NFTO with 126. And Team X just behind them on 118. And then the Vosvin girls with 105.
Yeah, I mean, it's always interesting. Day one, five rounds, half the competition done. There's still a lot that could change, to be honest.
Today we've got some fast rounds.
Exactly. So one fast round for sure. The other two a little bit more workers. Although we were talking earlier, it looks like that that third round today could be pretty exciting too.
I think it could be pretty fast.
Yeah.
We'll see.
And in the Open, the top five, fifth place currently in the Open. Let's have a look, count them down.
Okay, so in fifth place, we got SDC Rhythm XP coming back with Doug after a bit of a break. Really good to see these guys. They've got 149 points. Just ahead of them, the Tigers, having changed coaches, settling into a new rhythm with Gary now at 152 points. Arizona Airspeed, very clean-looking team, 165. And then they have only 1 point spread to the Wimby High Rollers, who, as we saw yesterday, skydiving with a lot of flow, a lot of speed, maybe losing some more points. Straight out ahead of the field. Hayabusa, what is it, a 16-point spread between 16 one and
points.
Two.
So the story right now we want to be watching is that silver and bronze place. That's where the story is right now for this morning's action. We're going into the female category now. Team X are in the door. Over to the live commentary with Ray Ahmed and Pete Allen.
Okay, so we got 1320G, as Ray and I were discussing earlier. A bit more of a technical rounder.
It is, and a new block. Block 13.
Finally, yes. Hopefully there were going to be two new blocks drawn for this meet. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. We're just going to see 13, which we're looking at right now. And we're looking at mainly one technique, I think, that we're seeing so far, and that is with a double vertical at the start. You'll see it here, knees over. A very deep vertical from Team X, actually. Obviously, they've been spending some time working on this.
Of course, yeah. I mean, I think I first looked at it about 18 months ago, and it was still in its infancy of how it would actually fly it. But it looks like a relatively fast block.
Very straightforward. I mean, block six, it really doesn't get more simple than this. I mean, the reason for the change, as we spoke about earlier, was fitting it into a tunnel and getting something that we could use comfortably in a 14-foot tunnel. Yeah. The previous block 13 would shave the knees off people, so
it's
nice to see something that fits a little easier.
And guys, it's great to see we've got the predictive scoring back. Tell us a bit about that. What's going on?
Yeah, the predictive scoring there in front of you. There's somebody there with just giving you an indicative score, is watching outside, has a little controller to indicate when the points are scored and when the bus is scored as well. However, it should be said, it's just an indicative score. The judges are looking at the footage and reviewing, and those scores will be formalised a little bit later on.
It's the best thing to hit formation skydiving in sliced booties. Pete Allen.
Okay, so this thing with the scores, fantastic. It's basically we're looking at the points going through the jive. Person watching today, let's see how accurately they do. We'll test them by the end of the day.
I'm sure yesterday we saw some variation in who was actually doing that point scoring.
Yeah. It went down really well yesterday. The comments that were coming in from the public watching, absolutely love it, Pete. Here's the Norwegians.
Okay, Vosvin, girls, very tidy looking team yesterday. A couple of small meltdowns, but generally managed to get back on track. Looking at how they do the less of a deep vert at the start for this team. Obviously got a slightly different technique they're working on. Oops, missing that catch on the 20. Going to slow them down a little bit. Still got a vertical, though, between the knees of the centers on that block.
Yeah. I think maybe with confidence and a little bit more experience, they might that vert might get a bit deeper.
I reckon so. So it looks like a projected score of 18, so 1 point ahead of Team X, which is a bit of an upset.
Yeah.
Although there could be some potential busts with the girls looking at
definitely.
That. Okay, here we go. NFTO, a fantastic team to watch yesterday. They're definitely going to put a show on for us today.
Yeah.
Could be competitive still for first. But it's basically, it's a three-horse race, yeah. I think, right now.
I think we definitely saw a different type of NFTO. We see variations of them from their squad, and they definitely came out the door bolt. I mean, they bolted out the door very much, is what I like to say. They're very much straight on it as soon as they get into the tunnel, whereas from the Wimby girls, we saw a little bit more of a progression through the dive.
Steady build, yeah. Mm. It did mean, of course, that NFTO were a little bit over the line on a couple of important points yesterday, which I think cost them, to be honest. Looking pretty confident out the door now on the 13 and 20 jump. This is one of the more technical rounds. They've chosen for a slightly different version of the 20, which gives a cog at the front end, if you can see that now. Now, that fits very well in the tunnel. Unfortunately, it's not helping them out for grips at the end of that block. It looks like a bit of a stumbling point, to be honest, for them.
The close isn't quite where they want it. They're chasing the grips for the close of that 20.
A very acute finish on the end of that block, making it a bit of a struggle for the catch.
It'll be interesting to see if anybody else takes that engineering as well.
Although, 1 point up on the opposition, or on the two opposing teams that have gone in, 2 points up on the projected score. So, look, long as there's no busts in there, it looks like a slightly faster round for the girls.
Knowing those girls, they won't be happy with that, Pete. Having spoken to yesterday, I think they're looking to score a little bit, do better within themselves today.
Okay, so we were just shown, there we go, accurate. We've got the French team now, Neftis Wimby. The new French girls team, the team that's going to be representing France, massive nation in skydiving and indoor flying. They're going to be representing at the World Championships in Lille coming up in April, 16th to the 20th. Okay, they've also gone for that cog on the front, flying a very deep vert at the start of block 13. It's also struggling with the catch ray on the end of that.
It's interesting. It seems that everybody's struggling with that at the moment. And I wonder,
there we go. Looks like they've nailed it now.
Yeah.
I'm pretty much expecting a couple of the top teams to be doing that in the open as well.
And maybe it's just a setup from a new block that, you know, people aren't ready work from the end of the 13 to the 20. Maybe it's just throwing people a little bit, the energy, momentum. I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah, I think it's that. I think it's the cog on the front with the shorter move into the G is what they're looking for. So that's where they're hoping to save time. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like so in practice.
Bit them.
There you go, the female category predicted 22. That's the end of the female category. And a very warm welcome back. It's early start. It's Friday morning, the 1st of February here in Ampure Brava Spain. Wing Games 2019 in the studio. Ray Ahmed and Pete Allen. We've just seen the female FS and we're shortly going into the open. Initial thoughts on that first round of females, round six?
No, it was good to see. I haven't seen the new block 13 in full force and it was good to see it. And some interesting engineering there.
Teams were struggling a little bit. They were taking the cog on the front of the 20 in the hope that they were going to shave time to the G. Didn't look like it was working too well for them, to be honest.
It didn't.
And just for the people watching back home, just give us another recap on this predictive scoring, Pete. What we're doing, it's not live, it's not the actual scores, is it?
No, exactly. We don't actually have a judge taking scores there. We have someone who's in a position of responsibility, if you like. They're counting the points as they happen, and they're giving their idea whether they think it's a bust or not. So the judges will come back afterwards with the official score.
Thank you very much. Let's go to the action in the tunnel as we start the open category with Ray Ahmed and Pete Allen.
So in the tunnel now, we have a team we haven't seen before today.
Yeah, Team Chimera. They missed the boat a little bit yesterday. Nice to see them back. They were given the opportunity to catch up on the rounds.
Exactly.
Does unfortunately mean they're going to be categorized as a guest team for this competition. Although we're still going to see them fly and they're still going to get the competition experience.
These guys have been training well. They're a UK team. They did have a bit of a mess up on their flights. Miscommunication amongst the team, but I'm glad they made it. Obviously being coached by Nicholas from SBs. And they really want to show what they've been doing. They've been training hard during the winter. I look forward to seeing what Chimera do in the future.
Absolutely. Love watching young teams, especially coming out of the UK. You have obviously a strong connection with the place. They've gone for more standard engineering. They've gone for the regular move on the 20, very deep vertical on the previous one, and it looks like they were trying to fix that on the next time round, almost landed on top on one of those 20s before. So that's Chimera with a projected score of 19 for that round. Let's see what the judges say.
I actually prefer the standard engineering, I think. at the moment.
Looked like it had more flow to it.
Yeah.
Slightly longer move into the G, slightly more standard moves. I think you'd have to have trained quite a lot that other engineering.
Although I do like that cogging 20 as well. I remember being an outside centre, I preferred it.
In a smaller tunnel? Yeah, although I must admit, I found a few secret things that helped me out on that.
Maybe
I'll share them with you later. Right?
Yes, please.
Okay, Team Papaya now. The Spanish teams we got flying not just in the wing games, but also in the Spanish nationals, which we have currently happening at the same time. So we have two military teams, Papaya 1 and Papaya 2, Barak, Alacran, and Winterbona Angels, all competing for the right to represent Spain at the World Championships coming up in April.
And, they're doing pretty good at the moment. I mean, Papaya, this is Papaya 1 now. I was a bit confused yesterday between them both, but they're both performing really well.
Do you know we had one of the Papaya flyers in the solo speed as well yesterday?
I heard that, Regan. That's fantastic. Yeah. I'd love to see cross-pollination through the events. Ray, of course, leading the game there.
Yeah, great to see Ray in the dynamics yesterday. Predicted 20 for Papaya, Pete Allen and Ray.
Okay, so very decent projected score from Papaya on that last round.
So that was Papaya 1 we just scored, and they're currently on a 24 average after five rounds.
Okay, Lesa Franchise. Now, I need to, a little apology here. I misconnected a coach to a team yesterday. The team for this group, Lesa Franchise, with Cindy, is Julien from the Wimby High Rollers. Doing an amazing job with this new team. This is their first competition. Yesterday was their first five rounds of competition together. Let's see how the guys get on today with the new block. New block 13. All right, engineering-wise, looks like standard. So they're a right-hand door team, so it'll look a little bit different to some of the other teams that you'll be looking at, which we find most of the French, Italian teams using the other continuity. But they've gone for standard engineering on this very technical skydive.
And for those at home, the continuity comes from the plane door, right, Pete?
Exactly, yeah. So Pilatus Porter being the standard aircraft in France, and the Twin Otter in the rest of the world, if you like. Okay, standard engineering, new block. Not seeing anything really fancy with this new block apart from varying degrees of vertical.
And guys, let's start our little game again. What do we reckon the top score is going to be on this round? Where are you going to place it?
Somewhere potentially around the 30 mark, I think.
Yeah, high 20s, I think. Yeah. I think just the highly technical nature of this block is going to make it one of the slower rounds.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, the slow round now with high 20s.
I know, it's crazy, isn't it? We were talking about when you first started doing four-way, the World Championships were winning with, what, a 12 average or something?
With a 12 average in the mid-80s.
Incredible. Yeah. Echo Chamber, guys, with Ray and Pete.
Okay, Echo Chamber, team always to watch. Very exciting team to watch. They have Matthias coaching them.
Yes.
They have a very regular training schedule. They train every week and a half.
Yeah, it's great.
In their local tunnel. Which obviously, you know, consistency in training in any sport is going to put you ahead. Engineering, Ray, what are you looking at?
Oh my, that looks standard to me, but I'm not sure.
No, it's got the other turn on the front of the 20. Again, they're going for that very short G build. Super deep vert on the 13s, kind of what we're expecting. To be honest, they look like they're doing a way better job than any team we've seen so far on this slightly different engineering.
But you would expect that from Echo Chamber as well. They would have dialed it in and they would have trained it.
I'm sure they've trained that 20 equally with the other one. So there's about three different block 20s that teams can choose. You know, they've got the cog, the shear, and then switching the other insides
of course.
On that. 24 is a projected score.
Yeah, it's the biggest one we've seen so far, Pete.
It's looking good. Echo Chamber look pleased with that as they exit the tunnel.
Here come the Dutch.
Out of the blue.
This is the Dutch project team, or it was a project team. Unfortunately, the project has folded, but this team has chosen to keep competing together in this lineup with Bart back on the team.
That's great. They're doing really well, actually. Out of the blue, we're currently on a 21.4 average after the five rounds.
Nice. So their highest average in a meet so far was 22.3. But with that faster round coming up today, we could see them nudging up a little bit on the scores.
We must say to Bart as well, congratulations. He's a new uncle. His twin brother, Wim, has just, they've had a baby. So
nice.
Congratulations to you guys.
Okay, standard engineering 20. From out of the blue. slightly longer build into the G. Very familiar slots, though, for everyone.
Yep.
And a more standard sort of block 20. So this is the way we generally start flying this block.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever we have a longer random in there, it always kind of throws a little bit of a spanner into the mix as well with levels, and it may slow the flow of the jump down. Something I'm sure you're noticing from the outside, yeah, whether you're a four-way jumper, a geek like us or not, is the difference in speed round to round.
Exactly.
You know, you have some rounds where a 25 seems like a very good score, and other rounds where a 25 would be the low end of the skinch.
17 predicted.
Out of the blue there. And what I really like about out of the blue is the communication through the dive. They're very light on the grips. They're actually waiting for each other's big eyes, but they're still, I mean, their technique is fantastic.
You know, listening to Pete Allen talk about four weight takes me back 20 years to being in the in the debrief rooms at DeLand.
It takes me back.
We've all been coached by Pete Allen, haven't we?
It's like, yeah.
What an honor to have been coaching you guys.
Thank you very much, Pete.
Okay, so here we have the bottom of the pack in the Spanish Nationals. Doesn't mean Dave's not over yet. We've got five more rounds to go today and tomorrow. Windebunner Angels, the team from Madrid, they're competing for the right to represent Spain.
Yeah, they do. And I think these guys, they're going to come into their own. They're looking a bit nervous on day two. They did on day one. I'm hoping they begin and see a few more smiles. You can see they're really concentrating on what's coming up. It's a new block, but it's a new block to everybody.
Yeah, and something not to forget, this is this team's first ever competition. They have done about 8 hours training together, but this is their first time out in public, if you like.
I know how that feels. And they're doing a great job.
Okay, so this team, were actually three of them were competing in AA last year at the World Challenge, and they got an 18 average. They're now being coached by Marco, who's taken them up to the World Challenge, I'm sure, again this year. And then let's see more from this team in the future, I'm sure.
So, guys, Efren on the live stream says, it looks like four is too many in there. They should do it with three.
A new dive pool coming up, right?
There we go. Three-way formation skydiving. There's plenty of space in there. Look at the Tigers. They seem to make it work rather well.
They do.
Okay, so standard engineering, which is exactly what we would expect that Marco had guided them to on this particular round. And they're acquitting themselves quite respectably.
Acquitting. Good word, Pete.
Thank you.
I like that. Again, we're seeing a little bit more of the patience, the communication, you know, starting out slow. Make sure you're on and off the grips together. That's what you want to do in a team that's starting out, right, Pete?
Especially with a jump like this, highly technical. They kept it really calm. A very nice showing from the Windebunner Angels. Good start today, guys. Let's see how you go. Okay, so Rhythm XP. One of the two teams come from the USA. Yesterday, we noticed how they were taking their formations in long lengthwise. And Ray and myself were both scratching our heads over this, wondering why. Had a little chat with the team this morning. And it's for Doug. Doug has only recently got back into the team due to a massive injury. And as you can see again here, they take it out long ways, which is going to be slower on the time, but it allows him to get a comfortable exit without hurting himself.
Perfect. And that's a great, I mean, thanks for finding out, Pete. We were you know, curious about it, and at least now we know why. Yeah. So, you know, that might cost them a point or two, maybe, depending upon the
It may cost
the
them a fraction of a point, barely a point. Okay, so they're going for a slightly different look at the 13. Mm-hmm. They don't have a very deep vert at all with the first two. Unlike some of the teams we're seeing with a massive vert at the start of the new block, we're just seeing a shaving of the knees and then a deeper vert thereafter.
So for the people watching back home, you see that bottom right graphic, that is the predictive score. And the reason it's a zero there right now, maybe the person doing the predictive is just on a break or something. It's nothing to do with the actual result of the competition.
Very decent looking round though. Without the projected score, we don't know for sure, but
it looked good.
Fast round, yeah.
And it'll be interesting to see how that the difference in technique for Block 13 is going to develop from some of the other top teams as well.
Absolutely. So the Hungarian team, are we there yet? They said they had a really good day yesterday. I caught them on the stairs this morning, said, how did you guys do? They said they're loving Spain, they're loving Windor, and they feel very comfortable with where they're at.
And they're in the middle of the pack at the moment. They're sitting on probably about a 19.4 average, and they'll be pretty pleased with that though, right? They were looking when I spoke to them in the earlier yesterday at a 20-21 average. So maybe
Yeah, the day's not over. I mean, we got that fast round with block four coming up later and three randoms that could change it. This would be a good indicator, actually, because if they can do close to a 20, so an 18, they're 2 points down on their projected average.
Yeah.
But it is a slower round, Ray. So, you know, let's see how they back that up on the slightly quicker rounds.
I mean, just to recap for everybody at home, we discussed this yesterday. It's a pretty straight up kind of draw, right, Pete? I mean, you've got some technical rounds, you've got some semi-fast rounds, quite fast rounds. And it's pretty much what we're seeing a lot on the moment, you know.
Yeah, as you said, it's a working draw. There are some quicker rounds, but there is no pure random rounds.
That's right.
Sorry, go on, carry on. I was just going to say a big shout out to our good friend Jason Cook from Cookie Helmets, who's just joined the live stream and he's just landed in the USA.
Very nice. Cookie, good to hear from you, man. Keep
Morning.
Watching. Okay, so next up, I believe it was Barrack.
Barrack, yes.
Right. Barrack, another team competing in the Spanish Nationals that we're holding at the same time as the Wynn Games. Bit of a grip switch into the first point. It's not a bust, it's just the way they get in, just like you would from an aircraft maybe. Very standard engineering, shearing the front of the 20. Let's look, very deep vert.
Very deep.
So there's another team that's being coached by Marco. Looks like he's favoring as a coaching technique for this for this block, a very deep start to the block, which I'm kind of liking, I must admit.
Yeah, it looks good, but we're seeing here from Barrack that the communication's just broken down a little bit. Maybe because it's a new block, there's a little bit of reaching going on for grips. Communication's not all there. You know, people, they're not on and off grips at the same time, which, you know, we've seen from some other teams, stop, wait, lock it down. So they'll be a little bit disappointed with this, I think, but
think so. Yeah, that thing about reaching for grips, Ray, we did bring that up yesterday, and that is it. You know, it when you see teams starting to stretch their hands out reaching for grips, you know there's a level of panic in there that you don't want to see in the middle of a four-way jump. And one way teams can work on that is just literally just keeping a good body position, and it will keep things close, it will keep you calm, a good centered position to get on with the rest of the round.
It is like being back in the cabin behind me, Pete. That's
okay.
What it feels like.
So pressão, which means under pressure. Here are the boys from Brazil. They flew over the day before the competition. This is their first time out of Brazil in a competitive lineup. They were a free-fall team, had a couple of injuries, which made them stop about 15 years ago. And they started flying in the tunnel just to keep things going. So a bit of a shaky start to the top of this round. Let's see if they manage to refocus and keep things going. It looks like we've got a couple of potential busts at the beginning of the dive, although it does look like they're locking it down right now, keeping that 20 piece in the middle of the tunnel.
And that's a hard thing about block 20 in the tunnel, because you've got like so much going on around you. You want to keep that the center of that 20 locked down. Oh dear.
Bit of a hiccup there on the 20. And so one thing to notice on this team is Fred, the guy in the back, he actually doesn't have a leg below his knee. He lost that in an accident, and he's doing an amazing job working his way through tunnel flying.
It's incredible.
Without that, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank God for booties, huh?
Very good morning. If you just joined us on the live stream, it's day two of the action here from Wynn Games 2019. Ray Ahmed and Pete Allen are here in the studio, taking you through all the formation skydiving. It's round six of the action. Five rounds done yesterday. Still to come today, all the action from yesterday, plus the Freestyle Open and the Freestyle Juniors. It's Alacran with Ray and Pete.
Alacran, getting ready.
Another team from the Madrid area. Again, another team. We got four or five teams competing in the Spanish Nationals holding concurrently. Let's have a little look at what kind of engineering we see from these guys and the new block. Straight out the gate, they're launching the block, which pretty standard, I think, for this block. Pretty easy one, a bit like the F launch, with just that compressed in the center. Okay. Struggling a little bit with memory.
A little bit backwards there on the grip.
Okay, so something that we find a little confusing is when teams include red on their jumpsuit choice. You can see that here. It's a little bit of an interesting color to be looking at on the screen. It's nicer when we see the monochrome look with like a plain dark background on the suit and the white gloves.
Back in the day with our four-way, when I was doing four-way, nobody was allowed to have red grips because the video, the VHS, it would just bleed all over the image.
Yeah, we're seeing now with digital film format, obviously much less of that, but it's still, do you not find it a little confusing when you look at it?
Team Monaco as well with the red.
Yes, yeah. Well put. So 16 on the projected score, eh? What do you think?
Yeah, That's pretty good. You know, the other thing I don't like is the double grips now. And the more and more I watch it, I'm like, why do we need them?
Yeah, why do we need them?
Well, block 19 on an exit, that would be the time that we would normally use it, where you've got people sharing. But to be honest, the
21 grip, as well, maybe?
Maybe a little bit. But there's enough space on a single grip. And quite often I find people struggling for that, with that second grip getting in the way. To be honest, it comes down to the team's preference. You know, some teams are going to like it, some teams not. Here's another Papaya team right now, also with those double grips. It just looks, for me, it's confusing. I want to see a single clear line on a grip. And I think from a judging perspective as well, it probably
makes it
cleaner.
I'm with you on that one. I don't understand the two-grip thing.
I think for me as well, in free fall, on deployment, there's that much surface area on your legs. Your canopy's going all over the place. You've got to be really careful with your legs.
Have you been jumping a lot recently, Regan?
I have. I've just done 95 jumps in Seville.
Very nice.
So this is Papaya 2 or Papaya 1? Papaya 2.
Papaya 2, I believe. Looking with no vertical at the start of block 13. And engineering standard with a shear, although projected score putting them up at a 17, which for this round is a decent score.
I mean, out of curiosity, Pete, these changing of the blocks that we've had, like with 1 and 13, to fit them into the tunnel, do you agree with it? Do you like...
Okay, so I think the concept is good.
Yeah.
I like the concept of having blocks that will fit more comfortably inside the tunnel. Not necessarily super keen on the new blocks. Mm. Maybe give me a little bit of time to settle in with them. I just find them very basic. Although they should be easy to judge, apart from 13 when you've got that possible bust potential with that extra grip amongst the piece.
As in hiding the hand as it goes round.
Exactly, yeah. A bit like we see on block 10.
Yep. Yeah.
So the highest score we've seen so far on this predicted is 24 with Echo Chamber. Now these next teams are going to start pushing that up a little bit, guys.
Yeah, so who we got now, Ray?
Tigers.
Tigers.
Nice.
Okay, they could fit anything in a tunnel, the Tigers.
I mean, this team makes this tunnel look like a 16-foot tunnel.
Great.
Not just because their body size, just their fly tight together as well. I was having a little chat with Gary this morning, and he's saying that this is a transition period for this team. They've just changed coaches. He's working on a couple of basic things with them, smoothing them out a little bit, getting them to see a little bit more. You know, something that we're expected to see from Gary's style of coaching,
of
you know, giving teams that very easy to judge look, very smooth flying style.
And also some headspace confidence and things like that, I guess, it will come into it as well, which Gary has done with so many teams.
Yeah. And I'm pretty sure it's going to take a little bit of time for this team to transition from one coach to the next. But we're seeing some real good stuff from them already. And this is the beginning of their year of training with the Qatar Tigers.
That looked like a really good round for me. I mean, it looked a little bit close in the middle. So
very
hard
tight,
to
especially
see.
On the close of the 20s.
Exactly.
Yes.
And we'll see what the judges make out of that. But they didn't look like they had any hiccups and they flowed through.
So let's see if we can get the predictive scoring back. We missed it there for the Tigers. We want to try and get that back on screen for you. If we can, guys, Arizona Airspeed are next in.
That would be nice. So I see the projected score frame there. Let's see if the numbers start moving around as they leave. So Airspeed, this should be a bit of another good look at how this block could be done from a different perspective, the other side of the Atlantic. Let's see what their take on it is.
Straight out the door.
Here we go. Projected score is rolling on the bottom right of the screen. They are going for the shorter engineering, very deep on the 13. So there's the cog, short G build, and then straight into the 13 with a massive vertical.
It's incredibly deep.
Yeah.
It's like they're not even going anywhere. It's amazing. It's.
It reminds me a lot of some of the older blocks that we saw back in the 80s and 90s, actually, the way that this is looking. A very straight up block. Easy to judge, providing we keep that hand away.
Yep.
Certainly quite easy to do from a competitor's perspective. Looked at it with a few times now. And whether you're an experienced team or a very new team, this block is a pretty easy one to get used to.
You know, so far watching it and a predicted score there of 26, indicative score of 26 there for Airspeed, I'm not sure, like this the deep vert is, it's going to cost you a little bit of time maybe in the beginning. I'm not sure. It's just to create that vert that you're creating, it looks like,
we're not used to it. There's only one other block that we do that on, and that's block 18, and that's with a technique that no one really uses anymore as well. So maybe what we need to do is spend a bit of time with this new block, with a new technique, and get better at that instant vertical. Yeah. We do it on block 9.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's no reason why we can't start doing it at the beginning of a block like 13. again, look forward to seeing this block in Wimby at the World Championships in April. Talking about Wimby, here they go, Wimby High Rollers getting in, same kind of idea with the 13 and similar, exactly the same engineering. It looks different to some of you guys, maybe because they've got right-hand door engineering. A little bit of reach there by tail on the back of that.
There's a few reaches going on, actually, to be honest.
Although, synchronicity-wise, this team is looking better this morning than they looked yesterday, and waiting as well.
Exactly.
Looks like there's a lot more communication.
And that was what we missed.
Center point bust. Sorry, that was a very, very deep vertical there. I'm sure the judges will be looking for that. Didn't even consider that as an issue for this block. Ooh, and again there. So let's see what the judges say to the potential center point bust on block 13.
And just for everybody, center point bust, Pete, did you want to explain it quickly?
It's a bit like the offside rule. Have you got about half an hour?
Oh, come on.
No, it's pretty simple. You've got your two pieces and there's a center point within that piece, and that center point mustn't cross the center point of the other piece.
There you go.
So overnight leaders, Hayabusa from Belgium with a big lead. Was it 16 points in front?
That's
16
right.
points, yes.
Going into round six now to finish off the last flight of round six here on the Friday morning at Wing Games 2019 with Pete Allen and Ray Ahmed.
Okay, so 16 point lead. That doesn't mean that these guys are going to not skydive fast. I mean, this comes as a second nature to this team, is to try and do things as quickly as possible, as smoothly as possible. And they've gone top teams, same engineering, same technique on block 13, very deep vert at the start. And as we said, they're probably going to get better and better at that as we go through the year.
I was talking to Dennis yesterday just to figure out how can you get faster? You know, I mean, it's a question we eternally have.
Efficiency rate, pure efficiency. So we saw a bust there, maybe even two at the end of one of those blocks. A bit of a struggle for the tail. In fact, we saw a couple of teams struggling with that. I must say, the Wimby High Rollers did a better job locking it down on the back of that 20. They had some wide finishes, but they dealt with it slightly better than Hayabusa did at the beginning of this.
So you think it's 28 bust down to a 26, maybe, Pete?
Quite possibly. Let's see what the judges have to say. Did we get a projected score from the High Rollers on that round?
We did. I think it was 26.
Okay, so even with... Yeah, they could be pretty close on that round.
And a very good morning. Welcome and join us here in the studio, Pete and Ray. We've just finished off round six of the VFS, of the FS and the VFS, and shortly we'll be going into round seven of both of those as well. Full packed day here until 8:30 tonight, and we're going to be bringing you everything we had yesterday. We've got the four speed, we've got the two-way dynamic, we've got the solo speed, we've got the relay races, and for the first time today, the solo freestyle and the freestyle as well. Sorry, the junior freestyle and the open freestyle. And that's coming up right after we have round eight of all the formation skydiving, VFS and FS. That first round we've seen all the way through, what do you think?
Super exciting to see teams and how they deal with the new block 13, Regan. So Ray, what do you think?
I think we're gonna still be playing with it, as you say, Pete. I mean, I just think you're right. We have to keep playing with that block to see where we can make the most of it.
Well, thank you, guys. We're going to switch it up. We'll be back in a minute after this video with Ray and Raf Codre. We'll be in the studio with the VFS. Join us back in a couple of minutes.